Hi children, good morning. Now this time we are going to start a very interesting topic, that's sentence improvement for UPSC GAT English examination. Here, as you go on, you'll get more interest because you'll try to check your grammar knowledge. If you're good at grammar, definitely you'll do well in this sentence improvement. Now, sentence improvement questions are just like spotting the errors. In the case of spotting the errors, you have to find out the errors. In the case of sentence improvement, you have to improve the sentence. For that, your knowledge of English grammar is very important. If you are well equipped with the knowledge of English grammar, then definitely you'll be able to do well in sentence improvement. So let's start this session on sentence improvement for UPSC GAT English examination. Sentence improvement is a variation upon spotting error. In a spotting error question, you are asked to locate the error and take the answer. So you are asked to find out the error in the sentence and take the answer. Here you are asked to evaluate the highlighted part of the sentence and improve it by making it correct if it is incorrect, or appropriate if it is inappropriate, or a better sentence by changing it with a choice if it can be done so. This is therefore a more complex exercise. The error or inappropriateness may be in any part of speech, or in tense verb form or sentence pattern, or in the use of an idiom or a phrase or proverb. In fact, the improvement in the sentence can be done by correcting the error or making the meaning clear. So here, correction of the error or making it very clear, so clarity of the meaning. So there may be a correct sentence that you have to make it better. If there is error, that you have to correct it. We can illustrate it with this figure. So in the case of improvement of the sentence, what you have to do? Either you have to correct the error or you have to improve upon the sentence by making it very clear as far as its meaning is concerned. Now here the highlighted part will be there. For that there will be options A, B, C, D, and among those options you have to find out the right choice for the underlined word or the highlighted part, which may be written in italics. Now, let us see some examples to clarify. Look at the italicized part of each sentence. Below each sentence are given possible substitutions for the italicized part. If one of them, A, B, or C, makes the sentence correct or is better than the italicized part or makes the meaning clear, indicate your response against the corresponding A, B, or C. If none of the substitutions improves the sentence, indicate D as your answer. Now, the first example, they are waiting for her since morning. Our waiting is written in bold. So, you have to find out what will be the right choice for our waiting. Have been waiting, were waiting, wait, no improvement. Here in this sentence, the error is in the tense form. The correct answer is have been waiting. Now here, since is given. If since is there, since morning, you are showing the period of time. When you are showing the period of time, then you have to use perfect tense. So what you have to use here, have been waiting. Are waiting is in continuous tense, but what is required is present perfect continuous tense. Remember, if since is there, then and if you find that there is period, which is a longer period, then you have to make use of perfect tense. So present perfect continuous tense form would be the appropriate one here. Now let us see the second example. If you would have seen the movie, you would have enjoyed it. Now here the options are, had you been seen? If you had seen, had you seen? No corrections required. The answer is, had you seen? The error here lies in the tense sequence. According to the rules of grammar, when there are two actions of past probability, one dependent on the other, the sequence should be as follows: past perfect plus future perfect. Thus, the correct form of the sentence in this example will be, had you seen the movie, you would have enjoyed it. So if would have, when it comes, then what should be there? Had you seen the movie? So it should be had plus past participle. Then in the case of second clause, would have plus past participle will come. So if would have plus past participle comes, then earlier clause, what should be there? Had plus past participle. So past participle probability, when they are there, you have to find the right tense in the case of the first clause. Here, in this kind of questions, you may face lot of problems, because on one hand, you have to find the errors, or sometimes you have to improve upon the sentence. So let us see some more illustrations. So set number one of the illustrations. More than one person was killed in the accident. Does it require any correction? It doesn't require any correction. More than one person. Now here, this kind of phrase, when it comes, you have to use singular verb. So was, so it's right. So there's no improvement. Not a word they spoke to the unfortunate wife about it. In the case of this, you have to use not a word did they speak to the unfortunate wife about it. Now let's see the third one. The poor villagers have waited in bitter cold for more than 4 hours now. For more than 4 hours now, it shows period. When it shows period of time, then you have to make use of, then you have to use of perfect tense. And therefore, the right option will be A, have been waiting. Now let's go to the fourth example. If he had time, he will call you. Remember, the second clause is in simple future tense. He will call you. If it is in simple future tense, in the case of the first clause, you have to make use of simple present tense. So therefore, if he has time, so the answer will be has. So simple present in the case of first clause, the second clause will be simple future tense. Now here, in the case of fifth one, the error is in pronoun, all but her. It's wrong. So all but she had made an attempt. So all but she had made an attempt. So that will be the right answer. Now sixth one, I'm used to hard work. Wrong. So it has to be, I'm used to. When used to comes after that, you have to use verb. Which one is a verb? Work is a verb. Whereas hard is here adverb. I'm used to work hard. So that will be the right expression. Now let's see the seventh example. 20 kilometers is 1 unit. When 20 kilometers is 1 unit, the verb has to be singular. So R is wrong here. So 20 kilometers yields not a great distance. Now let's see the eighth one. They were working as usually. It's wrong, because the right expression will be they were working as usual. That is what we use in spoken language too. We don't say as usually, we always say as usual. He is unlikely to come to the party, but if he comes, I would talk to him. But if he comes, so there's nothing wrong with this particular expression. So no improvement in the case of ninth one. Let's go to the tenth one. The passengers have formed queue at the booking counter much before a train arrives. Before a train arrives, it is in simple present tense, or we call also call as present indefinite tense. So therefore, in the earlier clause, what should be the verb? What should be the tense form? So the verb has to be the passengers form, because the tense has to be simple present tense. The passengers form queue, so form will be the right answer. Now you must complete this work up to Sunday. Wrong. You must complete this work by Sunday. That is a right expression. If it will rain. Wrong one. We have seen already this. Whenever there is simple future tense in the case of one clause, if is there, if clause is there, then in the case of if clause, it will be simple present tense. If it rains, so it should be if it rains, the match will be abandoned. This kind of question quite often appears in the examination. You remember this, it's a very, very important. If clause comes, then you have to use simple present tense. Now let's see these last two examples. How long do you think? Do you think? So it's in present tense. So Mr. Kamal knows John. How long do you think Mr. Kamal knows John? So simple present tense, simple present tense. Again in another clause. Remember this. I have still to meet a person who is perfectly satisfied with his job. I have a car, we can say. But you have to say, I am still to meet a person. So right helping verb will be am, not have. Have will show the position. I have a car. I have a house. So I am still to meet a person. So that will be the right verb. I am instead of have. Okay. So right phrase will be I am still to meet. Right. With this we come to end of the first set of the illustrations. We are going to have some more practice. So let's learn some of the rules whenever we are going through these illustrations. So let's start set number 2 of the illustrations and let's learn some more rules of grammar so that you can do well in sentence improvement questions. Now let's take up the first example. Deepak will be able to speak Marathi well a year from now dash he works hard. Now the right option is here provided. What does provided mean? Provided we use like if or on the condition that. That is what is the meaning of the word provided. So provided is very important here. And remember here, Deepak will be able to speak Marathi well a year from now, and here we are using it as a conjunction. So provided he works hard, on the condition that he works hard, if he works hard. So the right answer will be option D. Now let's go. He was charged a whole series of crimes. So he charged with. So what you have to remember, which preposition will follow which particular verb? Charged with, accused of, died of. So you have to remember, along with charged, what should come? Which should come? He was charged with theft. He was charged with murder. So he was charged with a whole series of crimes. Rajesh Kumar has a dash the Filmfare Award for the best actor in several films. Quite easy. Received. Rajesh Kumar has received the Filmfare Award. Since Amit was a, now here amateur is the right option. Amateur photographer, he did not charge any money for taking our picture. Now he would have charged if he would have been professional. And what is opposite of amateur? Professional. So amateur, he was doing photography because he was interested in that. He had a hobby. He was not, it was not his job. It was out of his own interest. So therefore he has not charged any money. If he would have been a professional photographer, definitely he would have charged. So opposite of professional is amateur. So right option is A, amateur. So who does it? Out of interest. He had a dash shave when his car narrowly missed hitting the truck. So here the right expression will be he had a clean shave. And you have to remember this phrase, a clean shave. What is clean? It's not clean shaven face, but here clean shave means here it's a narrow escape. So he narrowly escaped the accident. So he had a clean shave. He had a narrow escape when his car narrowly missed hitting the truck. You will be cured of this disease. We have seen charged with. Similar way, you have to remember which preposition comes with which particular verb. You will be cured of this disease. You will be cured of this disease. He died of malaria. So of. He died of coronavirus disease. So you have to remember that with which particular verb, what will come? In the well, water is only 3 meters from the. Now you are measuring the depth. So 3 meters from the surface. So that is the right option. You can dash into the well. You can dive into the well and take the bucket out. So dive would be the right option here. So these are quite simple ones. Your heart and lungs dash the cage made for them by your ribs. So rib cage. So rib cage protects our heart and lungs. So your heart and lungs occupy the cage made for them by your ribs. So right option will be C. Now when you breathe in, your dash fill with air. Your lungs fill with air. Right? Appropriate words you have to find out here. You dash out immediately after you breathed in. You breathe out immediately after you breathed in. So inhaling and exhaling. On account of overwork, he eats. Now you have to remember the right phrase here, run down. Or now here, run down, what does it mean? Tired, exhausted. On account of overwork, he is run down. He is unhealthy. It also can mean unhealthy. So run down, tired, unhealthy. Now Ram agreed to dash my orders. Ram agreed to carry out my orders. So carry on means continue, but carry out means execute. So Ram agreed to put into force my orders or execute my orders. He dashed on air of dignity. He puts on an air of dignity. Now puts on, so he bears on air of dignity. So he puts on an air of dignity. Put off means You delay something, you put off something, postpone something. It is difficult to dash her nonsense. It is difficult to put up with, tolerate her nonsense. This is difficult to tolerate her nonsense. His name has become a synonym with. So synonym with evil. So she's so wicked. So she's very malignant. So that's why evil. So synonym with evil. So she's so cruel. That's why evil. So genius does what it must and talent does what it can. So genius does what it must and talent does what it can. You have to find out the appropriate model here. If a speech is full of pompous, it is grandiloquent. You should know the meanings of all these words that you will be able to give right answer. Now, grandiloquent. Remember that verbose is very wordy. Bombastic, again, what does it mean? It means high sounding but little meaning there. Grandiloquent. Now, grandiloquent is who is trying to create kind of impression. So, similar way, pompous also means trying to create impression there. So, very stylish, pompous. So, that's why grandiloquent would be the appropriate one here. Even if it rains all day, I will not be able to dash my journey. I will not be able to put off my journey. Put off my journey means I will not be able to postpone my journey or delay my journey. So I will definitely go even if it rains. Although he was tired, he went on working. So the right phrase will be went on. Go on means continue. So he went on working, he continued working. That's the end of the first session on sentence improvement. Learn the rules of grammar. Refer Rain and Martin grammar book and definitely you'll be able to do well in UPSC GAT examination. Thank you.